Let's look at the answer to our cash quiz.
These three are very similar to the options we have when we want to get books from a library.
This is like going to the library every time we need to look up something, and clearly we don't want to do that. Main memory is just like the library, slow and very large, so if we go to the main memory every time, we're spending a lot of time just waiting for the main memory to respond with data. Having the small memory inside the processor core and bringing the stuff we access there is the approach of basically caching the memory locations, and this is very similar to borrowing the book from the library so that we can use it for a while we're interested in that topic and then return it. And finally, having a huge memory next to our processor and then bringing everything in there is solving some of the problems of going to the main memory, because this memory is hopefully somewhat closer to our processor. But this memory is still going to be large and thus very slow. So this is very similar to just building a library closer to home. Yes, you are saving some time on each access, but most of the time that you spend per access is still there simply because it takes a while to find data in such a large memory. So caches are exploiting spatial and temporal locality and overcoming the problem of having a slow and large main memory. Just like borrowing books from the library is exploiting spatial and temporal locality and overcoming the problem of accessing a huge library slowly.